Say goodbye to the Windows 11 mail program. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I have various gripes with Microsoft, and this is one of them. They have a long history of poor execution for the mail program that they include in Windows. It's not unfair to say that after Windows XP's Outlook Express, which was loved and used by many, it's been downhill ever since. Each new version of Windows since has seemingly had another different attempt at an email program. While it's not tied to a new release of Windows, all I can say here is, here we go again. Let's have a look. So if you've used Windows 11's built-in mail program, Windows Mail is called, you'll probably already see this admonition across the top that says, try the new Outlook. The new piece of information that I think has started to show up recently is that support for Windows Mail, Calendar, and People will end on December the 31st, 2024. That message means exactly what it says. As of the end of 2024, this program, the Windows Mail program, will no longer send and receive email. Presumably, the associated Calendar and People or Contacts apps will suffer a similar fate. Try the new Outlook has become more of an imperative than a suggestion. So, we'll do that. Click on Try the New Outlook. The mail program goes away, and it's replaced by the new Outlook mail program. This program includes your calendar and your contacts, and all of the accounts you'd already configured in Windows Mail. Like I said, it's more than try. Once you've turned it on, the new Outlook, this new program, becomes the default mail program for your machine. It's a fine email program, don't get me wrong. It's somewhat limited in terms of features, but it's fine. But there's a super important catch. The new Outlook is not Microsoft Office Outlook. So if you've been using Microsoft Outlook, as has been included with Microsoft Office for years, if not decades, this Outlook is not that Outlook. These are two separate email programs with two different sets of features. The only thing they really share is the concept of email and a name. Yes, it's super confusing. Among other things, this makes it exceptionally important to be clear and understand just which Outlook you're using when you're looking for information or asking for help. Now, there are rumblings, rumors, whatever you want to call it, that perhaps someday these two Outlooks, the Outlook that we just installed or started using in Windows 11, the new Outlook, and Microsoft Office Outlook, might someday become one. But given the huge feature disparity between the two, and it is huge, I honestly expect that to take some time if it ever happens at all. Now, if you've done this, if you've switched over to the new Outlook and you want to go back to Windows Mail, well, you can, but that's only going to work until the end of the year. Here's how you do it. We'll go over to Settings here in the new Outlook, click on General, click on About Outlook, and then down here is the button to Open Mail Now, Return to Windows Mail and Calendar. I've done it several times, simply in preparation for this video. I've had to go back to Windows Mail so I can show it to you. And yes, it does a little bit of a process to show you. It warns you that things are going to go away. You're asked for some feedback. For the record, you can skip feedback if you want to. And now the new Outlook is gone and your old Windows Mail program is back. But the warning is still there. This program, the Windows Mail program, is not going to work after December the 31st of 2024. So, what if you don't like the new Outlook, but you still are faced with this eventuality? Well, You have choices, actually. That's the nice thing about running an email program on your PC. You don't have to use the Windows Mail program. You don't have to use the new Outlook. You can download and install Microsoft Office's Outlook, the much more powerful email client that's been around for decades. You could install Mozilla Thunderbird. That's one I talk about often as a great tool to use not only for just accessing your email if you like, but acting as a backup for your email if you do all of your email online. EM Client is another good installable email program that you can use then in place of either of these. There are many, many others. In fact, alternative2.net has a list of email programs that are good alternatives to Microsoft Outlook. Bottom line, of course, is that Windows Mail is going away. There is no changing that. My recommendation is that you try the new Outlook sooner rather than at the last minute. If you find you can't handle it, then consider a different email program or relying solely on web access through your browser for your various email accounts. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/175872. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.